Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Wednesday Night Vortex. Now, the matchup on your screen, you can see the match card right now. First match is going to be a tag team match, which will be simulated, and we'll be watching the Hardcore Championship match, which is going to be T-Bar going up against Shane Hayes. A fatal four-way between Liv Morgan, Gigi Dolin, Dakota Kai, and Roxanne Perez. And the winner of that match will be the number one contender for the Vortex Women's Championship. And the final match, the main event, is Bobby Lashley, the leader of the Hurt Business, going up against the returning future Hall of Famer, the greatest in WWE, Vavian. So let's start off with simulating this first tag team match right here. RK-Bro beats the Hurt Business. Bobby Lashley definitely not happy with that, and I'll see you guys at the Hardcore Championship match entrances. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. It is time for the first match tonight. The first Wednesday Night Vortex show of 23. Coming out first is T-Bar. Formerly from Retribution, he's the last Retribution member standing in the company. Well, Shane Hayes. Oh, wait, this is actually going to be a crazy match. Because T-Bar is going up against his former teammate. You know, he's not Slapjack anymore. T-Bar is still T-Bar, but he's not wearing that goofy gear no more. Let's bring out his opponent, the Hardcore Champion, and his former brother. And here comes his opponent, the WWE Hardcore Champion, going strong with two defenses so far, Shane Haste, formerly known as Slapjack. And, you know, back when T-Bar and Slapjack were in Retribution, Slapjack was just a running joke. And T-Bar was dominating the tag team division with Mace. And now Shane Haste is a hardcore champion at two defenses. And T-Bar is making his Wednesday Night Vortex debut. Well, not really a debut, more like a return. And there you see Shane Haste is very fired up and ready. Former brothers go up against each other now. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Former brothers, now enemies. Shane Hayes with a drop kick. And not really enemies. This could be a friendly competition. It depends on how they take it. But there is nothing friendly about an Extreme Rules match. Ladies and gentlemen, Shane Hayes, formerly known as Slapjack, was a running joke in the company. T-Bar! Oh my god, springboard! You know, when he was Slapjack, he wasn't really expected to do much in WA except just be there for Retribution. Like, we expected him to just do the tag team part, but it was really T-Bar and Mace dominating the tag team division while Slapjack was just waiting. Oh my god. And as you can see, T-Bar is already willing to do anything possible to win his first championship in WA, even if it means bashing his former ally with a steel step. And now Shane Hayes landing on his feet. Gonna go for a suplex on the outside. Falcon Arrow! You know, like I said, these guys are former teammates. They know almost everything about each other. They were a tag team for a long time in this company. And Shane Ace with that punch to the head of T-Bar. You know, it already looks like T-Bar doesn't really care about the former allies aspect. You know, already bashing Shane Ace with a steel step. And now Hayes is gonna get ready to retaliate. Kendo stick in hand. Uh-oh, he missed that first whack, but he got the second one. Oh my, look at him taunting with the kendo stick and continuing the assault. And now T-Bar gonna finally stop all that. Went to throw him in the ring, little failed there. You know, we saw Shane Haste retain the heart. Oh, what the hell? Okay, we're not gonna talk about it. Steel step standing upright, and now Haste throwing T-Bar. We saw Shane Haste retain the Hardcore Championship in his first in-ring defense. Two nights ago on Raw. Oh, kendo stick by T-Bar. Oh my god. And now T-Bar gonna flex with that kendo stick, and Hayes is gonna stop it. But T-Bar gonna reverse again. You know, Shane Hayes got his first defense on Raw. It was against the glorious Robert Roode. And now he's back on his home brand tonight on Vortex. Uh-oh. T-Bar bridging a ladder. This is something new. But Shane Hayes gonna waste no time. You know, T-Bar is so focused on using weapons. I understand this is a hardcore match. But, you know, you got to really focus on your opponent first. And that's what Shane Hayes has been doing. But now T-Bar with the reversal. And Hayes with the reversal. The back and forth. But now the headbutt by T-Bar. And he's going to pin him. Only a count of one. Hardcore champion Shane Hayes. Going crazy. Oh, my God. Shane Hayes jumping over the top rope to attack T-Bar. And now throwing him into the ladder that he set up. Oh my God, what is Hayes doing? Hayes setting T-Bar up on the ladder and attacking him one time. Oh my God! Oh! And now T-Bar gonna make Hayes pay. Oh my God, just throwing him. Shane Hayes went for a very big move, but got his back meeting the ladder instead. And now these guys just constantly going back and forth. And now T-Bar finally gets a hold of Shane. What? I guess a crowd member got caught his attention there. And he got confused on what he wanted to do. Shane Hayes throwing T-Bar into the barricade again, though. And now going to continue the assault kick to the head. This is not a traditional hardcore match. It's not false count anywhere. It's only extreme rules. And now Shane Hayes throwing T-Bar again, just throwing him across every inch of the ringside area. And now Shane Hayes has grabbed a steel chair. T-Bar running at him. Clothesline. Why did he just sit there and take it? You got a weapon in your hand. You see a big, tall guy running at you. You don't want to use that? And now T-Bar is going to use it because Hayes hesitated. And he's going to pay for that. Look at T-Bar, just, oh, the assault with the chair, and now Hayes finally reverses, and oh my God, that lariat was vicious. And now Shane Hayes picking up T-Bar, gonna go for another suplex outside the ring. These guys have barely been focused on fighting each other, just brutalizing each other, throwing them to the steel steps, oh my God. And now another weapon gonna get pulled out. T-Bar's bringing the tables. Wait, what? You just threw it. What? I guess never mind. And now Shane Hayes throwing T-Bar into the barricade again. You know, this is just being these two guys throwing each other across the ringside area. The whole match. Oh my God. What's Hayes looking for? Oh! Step up in Zaguri there. And now Hayes attacking the legs of T-Bar. Very smart to attack the legs on a tall guy like that. And now T-Bar's finally up and meets him with a big boot. And you can see T-Bar's bleeding. And now he's grabbing steel steps. Again. Gonna try to assault Hayes again and he gets it. Oh my God, Hayes is bleeding as well. These guys are just trying to hurt each other. They're not. This is not. This is a fight. This is not a match. This is a fight. Oh, God. I don't know what happened in the fallout of Retribution for T-Bar to be acting like this against his former ally. Someone that he used to call a brother. God. And now T-Bar going to the top rope, but Shane Hayes gonna waste no time. Oh, what? Never mind. You know, I try to make a pun for his comeback in this match. Now the pin on Shane Hayes, two count. Try to make a pun, but this guy's just acting like an idiot in the ring. And now Shane Hayes gonna reverse the move and get T-Bar back on the ground. Remember, the Hardcore Championship is on the line. I don't even think these guys care about the belt anymore. Well, I think T-Bar has, but Shane Hayes. And now drop kick to T-Bar. And T-Bar gets right back up, but Hayes gonna waste no time. Falcon Arrow in the ring. With Hayes going out the ring and going right back. I don't know what he was thinking. Oh, but T-Bar caught him. He went for a running move there. Didn't get it. And now T-Bar setting it up. Got Haste up. Oh, don't feast your eyes to Shane Haste. And I think that's it. One, two. Oh, my God. After everything that Haste has endured in this match, how did he kick out of the feast your eyes? And T-Bar is going to get right back on the attack. Oh, my God. And now a pin again. One, two. Oh, my God. T-Bar has just secured the Hardcore Championship after completely brutalizing his former brother, Shane Haste. So should I say Slapjack? T-Bar has won his first belt as he is now the new Hardcore Champion. And now it is time for Fatal 4-Way action. I'm not going to lie, guys. This might be the best, biggest Fatal 4-Way we're about to get. And this is going to be the start of Vortex. In this Fatal 4-Way, the winner of this match will be the number one contender for Cora Jade's Vortex Women's Championship. Coming out first is Liv Morgan, former main roster superstar, now got drafted to Vortex. And you know what? I'm not even going to say that because Vortex is now basically on the same level as a main roster brand now. This is not no developmental brand no more. Vortex is going to show y'all that they are a real deal. Let's bring out the rest of the women in this match. And now coming out next, representing Toxic Attraction, making her WWA debut, Gigi Dolin. You know, one half of Toxic Attraction, her teammate JC Jane, also on Vortex. Gigi Dolin is in this Fatal 4-Way to become the number one contender for the Vortex Women's Championship. And she would make her teammate so proud winning tonight. Let's bring out the rest of the women in this match. And coming out next, another woman from Raw and SmackDown. It is Dakota Kai. Now, she was only on the main roster for a little bit because of the ending of NXT. But Dakota Kai is a former two-time NXT Women's Champion. So, this could be big for her winning this match. You know, she's very familiar with the championship scene. She's very familiar. She actually won number one contender for the NXT Women's Championship in a multi-woman match. So, this is not no new ground for her. Can she pull it off again? We're going to find out. Let's bring out the final woman in this match. And finally, here comes another woman making her WWE debut tonight. Roxanne Perez. Both her and Gigi Dolin looking to make big debuts tonight. Either one of them could be on the way to winning their first championship in WWE on their first night. Now, we got two veterans and two new women in this Fatal 4-Way. Who is going to become the number one contender for Cora Jade's Women's Championship? Let's find out. I don't even know what the crowd is chanting, but the crowd is very ready for this Fatal 4-Way. And here we go. The two veterans, Liv Morgan and Dakota Kai, going up against each other. And the two new debuts, Gigi Dolin and Roxanne Perez, also going after each other. Fatal 4-Way match. The winner of this match goes on to face Cora Jade at In Your House next month for the Vortex Women's Championship. Maybe not even In Your House. It could happen earlier. We never know when it's going to happen. And Gigi Dolin now going after the veteran Liv Morgan. Liv Morgan is a former... Oh, God! Look at Roxanne Perez already showing some aggression. You know, Liv Morgan is a former SmackDown Women's Champion. You know, she's also familiar with the championship scene. Both Dakota and Liv, former champions. Liv Morgan was a bigger champion, though, you know, going up against the big girls on SmackDown. But Dakota Kai still went against some tough talent on NXT. And now Roxanne Perez, the pin on Dakota Kai, only a one count. And now Liv Morgan going after Gigi Dolin. And now Roxanne Perez beats Liv with a dropkick, and Liv's going to roll out with Dakota. And the two new debuts going after each other in the middle of the ring now. Now Gigi Dolan, snapmare. Oh god, rolling. Oh, kick to the head of Roxanne. And now Roxanne with the reversal. Liv Morgan going crazy outside on Dakota Kai. And now Perez with the pin on Gigi. Only a count of one before Liv had to step in. And now Liv going after Perez. And Dakota Kai was going to try to go after Liv, but Gigi Dolan stopped her. And now, god, looks like Roxanne tried to get a roll up there. Didn't get it. And now Gigi dropping Roxanne. And Dakota going after Liv, but Gigi stops it. Suplex. Gigi Dolan going crazy. Only a one count on that German there. And now Liv Morgan going after Dolan, but Dolan reverses. Roxanne Perez is going to take a breather out the ring. Dakota Kai now. Wow. Nice move there by Dakota. And now Dakota going to go out the ring as Gigi also goes out. Dakota going to grab a fucking sledgehammer. Roxanne Perez to pin on Liv Morgan. Only a one count. Dakota Kai just hit Gigi in the gut with a freaking sledgehammer. Dakota Kai already showing how willing she is to go for the freaking length she's going for this women's championship. Like I said, Dakota Kai experienced in multi-woman matches. This is nothing new to her. And now Roxanne the pin on Dakota. You know, you got to be strategic in a match like this. You got to be smart in a match like this. You can't just hit all these big moves. Liv Morgan! Jumping across the ring and out the pin. Only a one count before Gigi breaks it. You got to be smart and you got to move tactical in a fatal four-way because, you know, you can't just go for all your big moves and then just try to pin like there's not three other women ready to break the pin. Dakota Kai with the kendo stick. And now Dakota reversing Roxanne. Liv Morgan back in the ring going after Dakota as well. Was going to throw into the corner, but Gigi stopped it. Now Liv Morgan dropping Kai. And back on Roxanne Perez. Gigi with a sledgehammer. She missed her targets twice. And now Liv Morgan just going crazy. Dakota Kai going to roll out. Now on the apron area. All right, hold on. Cut this out. I forgot to go on Do Not Disturb. And now Dakota Kai picking up a kendo stick. Running across the ring to where Roxanne and Gigi are. She was going to try and hit Roxanne. Roxanne evading into the ring, but Liv Morgan gonna handle her now. Nice drop toe hold there. Now she's gonna walk all over Roxanne and met with a kendo stick by Dakota Kai. And now Roxanne with a running attack. And now Gigi Dolan gonna get back into this match. Gonna go for that little kick to the head again. And now Liv Morgan. Wait, Roxanne with the roll up, but only a one count. And now gonna get back on Liv Morgan. And now Dakota Kai, Irish whipping Roxanne again. Oh, nice arm drag there. Now going to pin Roxanne in the middle of the ring. Two count. And now Gigi Dolan locking in a submission. But going to get broken by Dakota Kai. Oh my god, the kicks by Kai. Oh my god, Dakota Kai is clearing house. And now focusing on Liv Morgan. Gonna give her a kick as well. And now the pin on Liv. Only a one count. Roxanne sliding to the ring. Broke that. Oh my god. And now Roxanne with the Dez press. And now Liv Morgan gonna grab Roxanne. Gonna put her on the ropes. We know what she's going. Oh. But Gigi Dolan not allowing it. Liv was gonna go for that oblivion. And now Gigi Dolan attacking the leg of Roxanne. And now Gigi and Roxanne got the ring to themselves with Dakota and Liv fight ringside. But Dakota's going to get back in now. Nice arm drag by Perez. And now Dakota with the forearms to Perez. And now she's going to try and grab her, but Perez not going to allow it. And now all four women are back in this match. Gigi Dolan. Oh, wow. And now the pin on Roxanne. Oh, only a two count. And now Liv Morgan and Gigi. And now Liv Morgan with the Thez press of her own. And now it is only Liv Morgan and Roxanne standing in this ring. And now Liv gonna try and put Perez on the ropes all the way across the ring. She gets it! And now Liv Morgan! No! Roxanne reverses the Oblivion. And now Perez! Oh wow, what a move! And now the pin up by Roxanne! One! Two! Liv Morgan kicked out. And now Gigi Dolin gonna get back into this match. Dakota Kai went for that kick, but Gigi blocked it. And Dakota reversing that. Oh, Gigi, nice reversal. And but Liv Morgan is still in it. Dropping Gigi. Now Dakota Kai gonna go out the ring to grab a kendo stick and gonna focus on Roxanne, who is walking towards her. And now Liv Morgan gonna continue her assault on Gigi in the ring. Nice reversal by Dolin. And Dakota Kai. Oh no, wait, Gigi in the ring! Looking for a big move on Liv, but Liv reversed it. Dakota Kai is asking for Perez to bring it, and she did. Liv Morgan and Gigi going back and forth in the ring, but now Gigi is done, and it looks like 201 face breaker on Dolin. And now Liv Morgan, the pin in the ring! One, two, kick out. Liv Morgan cannot believe it. Dakota Kai! Uh-oh, wait. Dakota Kai's putting a submission in. Roxanne Perez doesn't know it. Now she does, and she breaks it. And now Gigi throwing Roxanne in the corner. Dakota Kai! Oh, my God! The decapitator kick! The pin by Dakota, but Perez got out of the corner. Dakota met her with a knee. And now Dakota Kai with the assault on for Perez. Meeting her with all those kicks. The captain of team kick, Dakota Kai. Gonna grab a freaking baseball bat. And now Liv Morgan might be on the other end of that bat. Oh my God. Oh my God, the kick to Liv. Nice hurricanrana by Gigi. And now Perez gonna go outside the ring as well. What an amazing match that these women have been putting on. And now Perez, oh my God, the dropkick to Dakota. And Liv throwing Perez into the barricade there. Oh my God. This match has been a classic so far. All four of these women with a championship number opportunity on the line. Oh my God, what a nice bulldog there by Liv Morgan. And now Gigi Dolin and Roxanne in the ring. Nice kick there by Gigi. And now Gigi putting Perez in the middle of the ring. And all the women got back up. And now Liv Morgan was going to go for that. Oh God, Gigi with the kick again. Again, but this time to Dakota. And now Dakota Kai finally rolling out. And now Perez going after Liv Morgan. Wow, what a nice move there by Perez. But Gigi's up. Clothesline by Gigi. And now she's going to grab the baseball bat. Oh my God, the attacks to Perez. Perez reverses though. Now she has the bat. Gigi reverses, not going to let Perez use that bat on her. And now Gigi Dolin putting the submission back in. Oh, no, not a submission. Dakota Kai was already there, though. You saw her getting back in the ring. Oh, no. Dakota Kai with the kick. What is Liv doing? Liv Morgan realizes the situation and now gets back in and breaks the pin. Wait, Liv Morgan going to put a submission in on Dakota Kai? Perez breaks it. When is this match going to end? And now Perez gonna pin Liv Morgan. One! Broken by Gigi. goodness. And now Dakota gonna drop Gigi. Liv Morgan gonna go for that. Yup, she gets it. And now Roxanne Perez has a kendo stick. Liv was gonna go for a pin. Perez not allowing it. And now Perez and Liv going after each other again. Gigi Dolin back in the ring. Was gonna go after Dakota Kai, but Roxanne. My God. What was Liv going for? The world may never know. Want to do some jumping jacks, and Dakota Kai just steel chair to the back of Liv Morgan. And now a steel chair to Gigi. And Perez gonna stop the assault. Oh my goodness gracious. Irish whip by Perez. Dropkick to Dakota Kai. And now Perez with the pin on Kai. 1, 2, broken up by Morgan. And now Liv Morgan gonna put Perez on the ropes. Gonna once again look for the oblivion. Oh wait, no. Wait, she just clotheslined Perez out the ring. Oh no, never mind. Liv Morgan stopped because of the submission. Looks like Liv Morgan heard what was going on behind her. Oh, Dakota Kai gonna go for this cool little move again. And it connects. And now Dakota Kai focusing on Liv Morgan. The kicks to her head. And now gonna go after Roxanne Perez. Snapmare. Oh! And now Liv Morgan with the baseball bat. Oh my God. Dakota Kai finally getting out of that, but Gigi Dolin meets her the other way. Hits that finishing move again, but Liv Morgan is up and Gigi is still gonna pin in Liv's face. I don't know if this match is ever gonna end. Liv Morgan was gonna try and catch Gigi, but it didn't work. Roxanne Perez though. Oh wow. The pop rocks there by Roxanne Perez, but it got broken again. No woman is gonna get anything done in this match. And now Perez throwing Dakota in the corner. Nice uppercut there. And now Liv Morgan gonna get back in this ring. Dakota Kai finally rolling out. Roxanne Perez putting Gigi down on the pin on Gigi. 1, 2, 3. Liv Morgan went for a weapon and that was the downfall. Roxanne Perez got the sneaky pin on Gigi Dolin. And now we have finally, after that banger of a fatal four-way, we finally have crowned the number one contender for the Vortex Women's Championship. And that is Roxanne Perez on her WWE debut, already secured a number one contender shot. Can she go all the way and win the championship? We will find out when the time comes. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the main event of the night. Coming out first, the almighty leader of the Hurt Business, Bobby Lashley. This man right here led the Hurt Business, and the Hurt Business came down to Vortex after dominating SmackDown for a while. You know, the Hurt Business were SmackDown Tag Team Champions for a while. Bobby Lashley didn't really get to do much. But they went crazy on SmackDown. But Bobby Lashley is looking to make a bigger name for himself than he could on SmackDown. And that would be defeating a big name if he can. Let's bring out his opponent. And now here comes the future Hall of Famer. Already set in stone as a Hall of Famer. The most dominant, unstoppable force that WA has ever signed, Vavien, formerly known as Vavien Ospreay back in the days, formerly in a tag team with Pete Dunne, former three-time WA World Champion, two-time WA Universal Champion. He held both the Universal and World Championships at the same time at one point. He's held he's a Grand Slam champion. Fabian is just looking to solidify his spot in the Hall of Fame here in Vortex. Look at the pyro they gave this man. The only belts that Fabian hasn't won in his company is the Vortex Championship and the Vortex Tag Team Championships. Once he wins those, he will have won every belt in this damn company. And he won't have anything else that needs to be done. He's beat almost every legend we've thrown at him as well. Let's get into this main event match, man. The crowd is chanting Bobby's name. Here we go. Fabian's first Vortex match and running straight at Bobby. Oh my God, Fabian wasting no time on his NWA return. You know, after Fabian lost the Universal and World Championships, we haven't seen him since. You know, we had our first WrestleMania without him at WrestleMania 6. Now the pin on Bobby. Only a one count. Remember, this is a false count anywhere matchup. And now Fabian throwing Bobby back in that corner in the clothesline again. Look at how much buffer Fabian's gotten. Like, as time goes on, the man just gets stronger. All right? He becomes... Oh my God! Bobby Lashley jumping over the top freaking rope! And now we're already outside the ring. Bobby Lashley already making a big... And now the bear hug. Bobby Lashley already trying to take down Fabian. You can already see him trying to weaken the man. Fabian getting out of that submission hold quickly. Oh my God, the knee! That running knee must have hurt. And now Fabian, oh my God. Wait, the knees were up. Bobby Lashley getting right back up. And now a clothesline of his own. Oh my God. Bobby Lashley already picking up the steel steps. Fabian missed that kick. And now Bobby with the attack. Picking up the steps again. But that was a big mistake. And now Fabian picking up Lashley. Goodness, just dropping him. Now attacking the arm. You know, Fabian, we all thought he was going to retire after he'd done everything on the main roster, but now he decided he's going to come down to Vortex and check everything off the bucket list, throwing Lashley into the steps. You know, at first we thought that this was going to be an easy victory for him, but now that Vortex is one of the main three big brands, Fabian actually has to work. But he's worked his whole career! All he's done is work his entire career to make the name for himself that he has. And now the sledgehammer to Lashley! And now the pin on Lashley after that sledgehammer to the gut. Only a two count though. And now Fabian continuing the assault, but Lashley not going to allow it anymore. Nice reversal there. And Fabian not going to let him pick him up there. And now throwing him into the barricade. You're going to grab that sledgehammer again. Oh, God. Sledgehammer to the gut again. He's going to try to pin him again after that. One, two. Only a two count again. Oh, now Bobby Lashley went for a little roll up. The ref taking all the time in the world, though. Only a one count. And now Bobby Lashley is going to try and bring this back in the ring. And Fabian is going to follow. Both of these men already tired. And now Fabian throwing Lashley right back out the ring. Remember, false count anywhere. Kendo stick picked up by Vab, but Bobby's not going to allow him to use it. And the reversal by Fabian again. Oh! Bobby was going to try and... kick him by surprise again. Oh my God, the stunner. Oh my God, look at how Bobby fell after that. And now Fabian. Oh no, he didn't get that move. And now Bobby Lashley picking him up. How the hell is that supposed to hurt? Like realistically, how is that supposed to hurt? Oh God. Bobby going for a powerbomb, but Vav not going to allow it. And now the pin. One. Bobby Lashley getting right back up. And now Fabian. Oh boy. K360. And now the pin on Lashley. One. Two. a two count on the almighty there. And now Vavien gonna pick him right back up. And now Bobby Lashley gonna get back into this match. God, dropping him. Kendo stick to the head. One, two. Only a two count. And now Lashley getting frustrated. Gonna pick up the kendo stick. And now assaulting Vav only once. And now he's... What is with these guys hitting each other once with the weapon and then pinning? It's not gonna... Like, it's just one hit with a kendo stick. Now, the sledgehammer, I can understand. But the kendo stick, not so much. And you can see that by the one count that Lashley got from that. And now Lashley... Oh, God. Vav getting out of that. I don't know if he was gonna go for a hurt lock there. I don't know what that he was looking for. Oh, what the fuck? We're not gonna talk about it. Lashley getting pinned. One, two, and a two count. Lashley kicking out. The crowd is chanting fight forever. They are in love with this match. You know, these two big, strong men. Oh my goodness, look at Vav. Nice combo there on Lashley. And now the punches to the head. And now he's going to pin Bobby. Oh my, the ref going over the step to get the pin. One, two count. And now Vav thinking, what is he going to do to the almighty? And kicking Vav right off of him. And now the pin on Vav. One. Only a one count. We all know Vav able to get through the biggest of challenges. Able to kick out of almost anything. Now the kendo stick assault. And now Bobby Lashley knows he's going to have to pull out weapons if he wants to beat this guy. And now Vav with the knee. My God. Bobby Lashley laid out there. And now Vav going to go for the signature K360 again. And now the pin on Bobby. One, two, oh my God. Bobby Lashley is still in this match. The Almighty has not kneeled. And now Vav gonna throw Bobby back into the ring. And now he's gonna make this. He's gonna make him pay. He's gonna finish it all now. Wait, no, Bobby caught him! Oh my God, now the pin in the middle of the ring. One. Two count. Vav is still in this match. Bobby Lashley. Oh my God. Look at the blood on Vav's head. And now Vav is mad. Throwing Bobby into the corner. Went for that running clothesline. But Bobby not going to allow it. And now the reversal by him. And now Vav going to go right back out the ring. What's he going to? Oh no. Grabbing, okay, we're not gonna talk about it. Grabbing the steel step, and Bobby Lashley gonna get back out the ring. But Vav's bringing the steel step back in the ring. That's where he wants him. Oh, tried to cheap shot him, but it didn't work there. But Bobby Lashley reverses. And now Bobby gonna go for a suplex. Front facing one, that is. Oh no. Wait, what? Bobby Lashley's going top rope. Pulling out all the stops. Vav is too far. Yup, Bobby realizes that. He gets off the top rope. Oh my God. Bobby Lashley's trying to keep this match on the outside. And now he's going to pin Vav after just throwing him out. Referee running across. One, two. Another two count. Bobby Lashley looks frustrated, man. And now Bobby Lashley... Oh my God. And now another pin. What the fuck? Vav didn't even kick out at a count. And now Vav once again. K360. And that might be it. The pin on Bobby. Where's the ref? The ref took too long. And now Vav gonna bring this back in the ring. But he's gonna get a weapon first. He's gonna grab another kendo stick. And now we're back in the ring. And now the kendo stick assault by Vavien. Bobby's up though. Oh, he didn't get him though. Oh my God. And now Bobby with the reversal. kendo stick in his hand now. And now Bobby Lashley with the kendo stick assault. Weave! Reversal by Bobby. And now Bobby Lashley's looking to end it. No, back with the reversal. Suplex. Oh, he's not done. Into a clothesline. Oh, my God. What a lariat. Now Bobby Lashley on the assault. What? Bobby's grabbing the... Bro. Bobby. Bobby, do you not know how to hit somebody with a kendo stick? Bobby Lashley just straight struggling right now, trying to hit Vabian with the kendo stick. Doesn't know how to hit a target. And now Vabian finally weaving that, and now he has Bobby in the corner. Oh no. Mid-rope moonsault by Vabian. And now Bobby Lashley gonna retreat to the apron. And now Vav, oh no. Bobby getting back in the ring before Vav was gonna do something big. And now the pin on the almighty Bobby. One, two, three, that's it. Didn't even need a big move to finish him. Vabian has just beaten the almighty Bobby Lashley in his first Vortex main event. That match was crazy. Bobby Lashley was pulling out all the stops. He knew who he was going up against. He obviously studied Vabian before this match. But obviously, Vabian being the unbeatable dominant force that he is, not going to be stopped. Look at the blood, the battle scars. Vortex, y'all are in trouble.